Hello, and welcome to this video series on the Power BI Adoption Framework, which is about empowering every decision maker. I'm Paul.
And I'm Manu.
And in this video, we will talk about what you need to govern. Before deciding on how to govern Power BI, it is important to understand what tools are currently being used across the business and how Power BI will fit into this ecosystem. If you already have a governance plan for these tools, or self-service BI, then make sure this is available for everyone involved in making the governance decisions and planning for Power BI. If one does not already exist, then we would recommend documenting the current technologies, including who is using them, what types of reporting they're used for, and the future plan for these technologies. When introducing Power BI, it is important to understand and document what, as an organization, you are looking to get from Power BI. Do you want to consolidate your use of BI tools to just Power BI? Do you want to use it for self-service BI reporting? Are you looking to use it for real-time reporting or to host a dashboard on screens in walkways? Whilst you do not need to list every reason, knowing when to use Power BI and having some great use cases in mind will really help everyone else in the business understand why and when to use it.
Whilst the organization may already have a governance plan, there are a number of elements of Power BI that require consideration in order to support corporate and self-service BI. As an organization, you need to consider the various environment administration settings, such as the tenant settings you want disabled or only available to a subset of users. You also need to consider who will be responsible for making changes to these settings, or which users will be responsible for administering the enterprise gateways required to refresh data from your on-premises data sources. You need to understand and consider the security implementations of data in a multi-tenant environment and what data is appropriate to share with different groups of individuals within the organization. In scenarios where reports go through a development and testing phase, it is really important to understand how to configure this and enable rolling back to previous version. It is also worth considering whether reports need a consistent look and feel. You should also consider what source data are you making available to users to create reports and how you can reuse models that have been created by other parts of the business. For organizations without a data governance plan, or for organizations that are just starting out in self-service BI, it is really important to consider data asset governance. Which sources are going to be available to which individuals? How does someone request for access to these sources? To make these assets more accessible, should you be cataloging the data sources and defining the various objects that exist inside them? How can you ensure the quality and stability of the data sources you're making available? And most importantly, how can you ensure that once an individual has access to a data source, they are only seeing the data relevant to them and only sharing it with relevant individuals, following the principle of least privileges? At this point, you should discuss the key data sources that will be accessible for analysis. The intention for asking this question is to understand what the key data sources are and how they will be accessed. The action point here is to document the key data sources, what monitoring is in place on these data sources, whether these data sources are documented, which is more important in self-service BI scenarios, and if there is guidance around how to use these data sources. Also, make sure you ask about the location. If it is on-premises, you will need to make sure data gateways are covered later. In addition to documenting the answers to the questions listed on this slide, also provide guidance in the write-up on how to check and perform quality assurance on these data sources, how to catalog which sources are available and how they can be shared with others, methods to create definitions for fields and measures on these data sources, how to connect to these sources, and also create security guidance on any restrictions on how this data can be used. We have included a link to the slides that we've used in this presentation in the description below. Thanks for listening, and if you have any feedback or questions, please leave a comment below. See you in the next one.